Hello and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. Today we continue the songwriting series here at BusyWorksBeats.com/songwriting. And today we're going to go over how to rap. Now this seems very basic, but I've deleted so many songs from people who just don't know how to rap, even though they think they're rapping. Now this is not to lock you in a box and tell you how to do things. This is just to give you the parameters of rap and why it makes it so special. And why rap is so popular. So firstly, let's talk about rhyme. I'm not just going to say make sure you rhyme, okay, because that would be a 30-second video and you wouldn't get any value out of that. We're going to go over the underlying principles of rhyme. So in hip-hop, I see it all the time. People trying to rhyme a two-syllable word with a one-syllable word. I know you can get away with a lot in hip-hop, but if you want the audience to feel you, to feel the groove, to feel the rhythm, to build up expectation and deliver on what's called tension and release, you have to match rhyme syllables. So for example, if I'm trying to rhyme man with backhand, I mean, just random words, you can see one word is two syllables, the other word is one syllable. You could technically rhyme that way. It's just sloppy. It's a sloppy way to do it. What you want to think about is what is called male and female rhyme words. Now, I'm not going to get too heavily into terms in the English language because that makes it boring, and I want to make it easy for you and not create a whole bunch of terms that nobody can understand. But let's just start with male and female rhyme. Male rhyme is usually one syllable. Okay, so that's pretty simple to understand. Female is two syllable. So when you're writing out your lyric, one syllable stuff, you want to match with other one syllable stuff. So a quick exercise you can do, especially if you're freestyling, is come up with one word and don't write any other lyric. Just write one word and your brain will have to fill in all the gaps. And that's the magic of freestyle. You know, freestyle is a combination of delivering on the rhyme word and also creating an image or an imagination around the gaps. So for example, if I were to freestyle and I came up with something in my head along to the beat, and I would say floss, okay? So now your brain starts to trigger other words, and you wanna get in the practice of doing this. So this kind of delves into our other video. We're gonna go over how to freestyle, but let's just go over a quick exercise you can use, and that's to use male rhyme words, okay? Because this is gonna build up your vocabulary, almost like you're storing drum kits or storing sounds. You wanna have an artillery of words that you know can go in a chain. And you can always pull from those words. That's what freestyle is all about, is to have words lined up, knowing that they're male rhymes or knowing they're female rhymes, and you have a sequence, and you can always go through that sequence if you ever get stuck in the freestyle or can't think of stuff. So here's the exercise. You say floss, for example. So Ross, toss, boss, loss, moss. That's probably a cheesy rhyme word, moss. And then you can start to pick out words that are a little cheesy. Like in rap, you don't really talk about oranges, you know, you don't really talk about corny things like library. I mean, there are certain words that just don't fit the genre. But somebody can make it fit the genre. I'm not saying you can't, but there are words that you can pick out. Like moss would not be a typical word you'd use in a rap. So just mark that as a word that probably isn't going to have a substantial amount of influence over your rap. So we did toss, Ross, and if you really get stuck, go through your QWERTY keyboard, look at every consonant, and figure out how you can use that for your rhyme words. So this is floss, so I'm looking at Q, I'm looking at W, I'm looking at R, Ross, toss, yoss with a Y, P-O-S-S, I don't think that's a word, sauce, that rhymes, but it's spelled differently. So now we're starting to dig into phonetics, and language is all about phonetics. This is what makes hip-hop so fun, is because it's not always about the word, you know? For example, Meek Mill could say, rolling down the street with my top back. No, I got that Glock strap. You know, it's not about, so if we type out top back and then Glock strapped, these are two different rhyme structures. If we were talking about perfect English and perfect language, but again, hip hop goes beyond perfect language. We get to the core of it, which is phonetic or sound. And this is why Future is so popular. He gets to the sound. It's not about what he's saying. It's about the actual tone, the way we speak. For example, if I say, oh, my mouth closes up. Oh, my lips are forming what's called a low-pass filter. modulation. It goes, oh, it closes and then it opens back up. Oh, that is a vowel sound. It's filter movement. E, I, O, U. Okay, there are fluctuations in volume, tone, and filtering. That's what hip hop comes down to. We're starting to dig back to phonetic sound. This is what builds language. Language is built off of sound. For example, if I say, why haven't you gone to the store? You know, da, 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 da. My pitch goes up at the end. And that's how we recognize a question. That's why when you hear people ask questions, they're like, are you sure? And the pitch goes up. Okay, because it's phonetic. You know, even if you don't understand the language, you understand they're asking you a question based on pitch rising. So this is a phonetic language. This is the language of music. This is the universal language. It doesn't matter if they understand your wordplay or not. I've heard Russian songs that I've liked, even though I don't understand a word they're saying, or Spanish songs. I still like the song. And it's because it delves back into phonetic sound. So without digging too deep into all these concepts, again, going back to Meek Mill's example, I got my top back, that Glock strap. You know, it's ah, eh, ah, eh. You know, we're not focused on the Glock strap. You know, we're not focused on the end of the words. Top, back, you know, Glock, strap. You know, technically, depends on how you say the words as well. But we're looking at the vowel sounds. Ta, a, a, a. Okay? There are different vowel sounds for O, however. It's not always A. It's sometimes it's O. Like if I say toe, it's O. If I say top, it's A. So there are different vowel sounds for the same exact vowel letter. And this is what hip-hop focuses on. It's not about the word or the rapping. The rapping really deals with the story that you're telling, and we'll get into that later down the line in the songwriting series. But that is what makes hip-hop so special. So again, the quick technique and exercise you can use is just write a long list of rhyming words that fit the genre. You know, like I said, Moss isn't really something you'd say unless you're referring to the football player Moss, and that would actually make sense. So now we can take that off the kind of blacklist, or you know, a list of words we wouldn't really use. So that would fit. Now that we've understood the context or the reference there is to a football player, which is, you know, usually used in hip hop, the football analogies, basketball analogies, and all these references and movie references. So we have floss, Ross, toss, boss, loss, moss, sauce. You could say Gauss. I don't know if Gauss is a word or Gaussian. I know there's a term called Gaussian blur. We're not going to get into that. Cost. We already did cost, didn't we? Cost. And we didn't tie in cost. So even though cost goes cost at the end, it still fits that middle vowel sound. Os, 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 os. Notice we're not rhyming the end of the word. Floss. Boss. You know, we're not rhyming S's. We're rhyming aw, the middle sound. And this is what elevates above the English language when it comes to hip hop. So you can see we're starting to pull up different vowel ending. I mean, word endings, sauce, cost, but they still rhyme. So then you can go through the words lost, tossed, as in past tense. So you can continue that exercise. I'll let you continue that kind of list of rhyming words. So hopefully you understand the difference between English rhyme and hip hop rhyme. There's a lot more to it than just how it's spelled. You know, the classical question, what rhymes with orange? There's no rhyme with orange. So you can't, you know, in that dumb high school, you know, debate that all the other genres hate against hip hop, they're like, rhyme with orange. You know, it's very corny. But hopefully this enhances your songwriting. Again, it goes deeper than just winging it. Okay, there's a lot more to songwriting than winging it. Trust me. And we'll get into those characteristics as we move along the songwriting series here at BusyWorksBeats.com/songwriting. We'll leave a link below. You can click there to get started. Thanks for watching. It's BusyWorksBeats.com.